as a black woman, you're not protect. Y'all don't be protecting each other. Y'all sit there online too and diss each other and play each other and throw subliminal shots at each other. And anybody that you don't like that's a black woman, you're not screaming protect that woman.
It's time to talk about it. Way too much for me to ever go and walk around it. Niggas dead broke, you see the white chalk around them. Only a guilty conscience to think you talking about them.
It's your boy Jay Thrash back again with another one. Welcome to the channel. I hope you hit the subscribe button when you walk in here, man. Good to see y'all. Hope everybody feeling good. You know what I'm saying? Staying safe. You know, my regular stuff. You know, keep doing that every day. You might have woke up today on the wrong side of the bed. But that don't determine how you go up throughout your day. You know what I'm saying? Don't let your energy, don't let this bad energy just keep going and it just go throughout your whole day. You're going to ruin your whole day like that. Protect your energy. You feel what I'm saying? What I want to talk about today, and I'm going to start off by saying, if it don't apply, let it fly. Flat out. That's what I'm going to say for this one. You know this phrase, I see you, if you on social media even a little bit and you follow Shade Room or Say Cheese or any of these social media outlets, you know the phrase, protect black women. You've seen it. You done heard it. I know you have. I wanted to talk about this phrase and how I think it's manipulated in certain instances. For one, I'm going to say I'm all for protecting black women. You feel what I'm saying? I'm all for protecting black people. Hell, I'm all for protecting people that ain't did nothing to nobody. You feel what I'm saying? But I get why it's said because, yes, our black women are mistreated. You know what I'm saying? They are like the most mistreated and, you know, everything that come under the sun with that. So I do agree with that, especially when it comes to like domestic violence or anything of that nature or that status, for sure. For sure. We should all be in agreement on that. Where I start to disagree with the people who use protect black women is when they use it in instances where it just fits one side. It just fits their narrative. You know what I'm saying? Maybe you don't know what I'm saying, but this is what I mean. So Tristan Thompson's mom passed away a couple days ago, RIP. You know what I'm saying? Send the prayers to where they need to go for sure. But his mom passed away and it was on Shade Room. You would think that, and I, don't get me wrong, there was so much respect, you know, RIPs there. But I was alarmed when I seen how many women, black women, were in the comments and they were specifically only talking about him cheating on Chloe. As if that mattered, like this black man, this man didn't just lose his mother, a black woman. Now, this is why I say I be tending to disagree. I don't like the, it's, I feel like protect black women is overused and I won't say overused, misused by certain people who try to use it for the wrong reason. Now, this is a black woman who just passed away. Where is the protecting in there or the respect in there when y'all black women in the comments talking about this is his karma for cheating on Chloe? Where is the karma? Stuff like that, it waters down the phrase for everybody, for y'all in totality. And y'all have to understand that, because while I do agree with the phrase itself, when you start to see it get misused so much or it only fits one side, and it's like, we're supposed to keep that energy with everybody, dead or alive, that's a woman, that's black, especially one who just passed away. You should never downplay somebody's death as if the only reason that they died was because of somebody else's karma. Something that they did. They're trying to say that this woman died as a result of this nigga cheating with Khloe Kardashian. Now, this is black women that say this, though. And these would be the same ones, because I've seen them. Same ones that say, y'all don't protect. Talking about black men, we don't protect black women. We need to protect black women. But as a black woman, you're not protect. Y'all don't be protecting each other. Y'all sit there online too and diss each other and play each other and throw subliminal shots at each other. And anybody that you don't like that's a black woman, you're not screaming protect that woman unless what? Some domestic violence shit going on. But that shouldn't be the only time. What that should be the only time that it should really, really matter, and we should all stand in solidarity with it if it's real and it's, if that's really going on. Nobody should be on the side of the attacker. You feel what I'm saying? But when you start to use this for everything just because you don't like a certain black man that you didn't dealt with, and then you try to put that onto the whole all black men everywhere as if you know us all, like we don't protect black women, it's disingenuous and it waters down the phrase. So all I see now, I'm just breaking down why I think I see so much of the argument in the comments, and it's almost on every post because it's men and women on there just going at it with each other. And that's the thing with these social media outlet posts, man. They know what they doing when they post this stuff. They just want us to argue with each other. I found myself a lot the past couple of days just putting this same comment and like, yo, we need to just leave this stuff alone. Like, look, I'm like, look at us argue. Like, it was two girls in the comments, right? They going back and forth on each other. It was about baby mamas getting valued less because they got kids. Yeah, whatever that was, right? Okay, and that's I'm gonna definitely talk about that because boy, motherfuckers is crazy for even saying shit like that. It's just stupid, but they in the comments going back and forth with each other. Of course, they are disagreeing with each other, but it got to a point where they are now disrespecting each other. One is talking about their baby daddy ain't being there. The other one talking about you got hurt dirt. Like, you, like, what is going on here? And these are two people that don't know each other. Clearly don't know each other, though, because you can tell by the comments they don't know each other. They're just arguing. But this is what these posts are designed to do. Keep us just arguing and bickering with each other over stuff that really shouldn't matter to you, like, personally, that much to where you would disrespect and not protect somebody else that looked just like you that you never met before in real life. Y'all disagree on the opinion. Y'all disagree on the topic. So it's not a lot of protecting going on or respect going on in these comments when you see black women argue with each other and one side is on this side and one side on this side. You don't see all that protecting. Where's the protecting black women then? When y'all talking about each other or disrespecting each other, where is y'all? Are y'all protecting each other when y'all do that? Especially the people that don't know each other. And you can talk about the ones who know each other that got history and backstory and be on here, dissing each other, whatever, whatever. But what about the random people who would love to say that, though, when it's a man involved? Once a man get involved, you want to scream, protect black women. But as a black woman, a lot of y'all don't protect each other. And I'm not saying that we shouldn't protect y'all. We should. But don't act like there's not more than enough doubt in so many of us men's minds when we see what we see on social media, just like y'all see what y'all see on social media. Y'all see what we be saying. Y'all see how y'all how them men be talking about y'all and the ones who y'all feel like really hate y'all and stuff like that. Y'all see them comments and stuff the same way we see y'all talk about each other or talk about us. And then we come up with our, you know, assumption or perspective about y'all. It's the same thing because the energy is not being kept all the way around the board. So as much as I am with protect black women, I ain't protecting all of y'all because y'all use and manipulate that phrase to fit y'all narrative just when y'all disagree with each other. You know what I'm saying? Or you might disagree with me and then now all of a sudden I hate, like, yo, I'll be like, it won't even be an argument, a debate with a woman in the comments. And the moment we get to disagreeing and then I make a point, I hate black women. Oh, you must not know your mom. You must hate your mom. I feel sorry for you. Like, what is all of this? What is all of this? And then we'll say protect black women. But you just gave me a clear case on where you don't even respect me enough. So why do y'all think that when y'all show the amount of disrespect that y'all show to men because they show the disrespect to y'all, why do y'all think then that most of these men out here gonna put a cover over y'all and protect y'all from what the fuck is out here, man? You gotta keep it real. Just keep it real. I'm just saying, just keep it real. Like I said, if it don't apply, let this shit fly. Y'all know the phrase. But I'm so serious, man. How y'all feel about that? How y'all feel about what I'm saying? I know somebody gonna be in the comments like, oh, and somebody probably still gonna come in this video like, you hate black women or some dumb shit. You know what I'm saying? Something dumb that don't even make no sense. Because we don't care enough unless it fits our perspective or our opinion or our narrative is when we try to really go hard and stand for something. But then we don't be standing for them same things when it's somebody who we don't like. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I don't like this person, I'm just saying, keep the energy all around the whole time. If y'all want to see a surgence of men out here protecting y'all, you still got to protect yourselves. Like, y'all on here showing on social media that y'all can't even get along and y'all be dissing each other. And I'm just, that's what it is. I'm from a man perspective. So I can see why a man would say, I ain't protecting y'all. Like, yeah, he talking about the ones who be on there displaying the shit that you ain't supposed to protect. But then y'all use that same broad term and put all of the black women under that, as if they all fit under that with y'all, the ones who really mean that shit. No, that's just not how the world works. And this can be whatever y'all feel on the other side, like vice versa. You feel what I'm saying? Like, cause we're not no better. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, men ain't no better in the things that they do. I'm just calling out the hypocrisy, but we are just as much as hypocrites as well. Somebody gonna probably find some hypocrisy or what they think is hypocrisy in this video right here. That's fine. Talk about it. Let's talk about it. I'm not opposed to talking about this shit. You know what I'm saying? So it is what it is. But let me know what y'all think in the comments, man. Please hit the subscription button. Share this with a friend. I really want to know what y'all think for real, man. Like I said, I love black women. I love my black women. I love my mama. So they be trying to kill me with the comment. You must not love your mama. I just got off the phone with my mama before I just made this video. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, but that's what I'm saying, though. That's even disrespectful to my mother who raised me to love her. You disrespecting her raising abilities, her skills and raising me. Where's the protection there? Just pointing out to hypocrisy, man. But y'all stay safe, stay easy, stay protected. Get them folk out your circle that ain't supposed to be in your circle. It's easier said than done. But it's definitely doable, man. I'ma see y'all, man. Y'all hit the subscribe button. We on the way to 1,000, baby. I'm not playing. When you manifest it, it come true. That's all I'm saying. So make your shit come true. Feel me? I'm out.